fans, and welcome to tonight's game between the Iowa State Cyclones and the Oklahoma State Cowboys. We've got two very good small forwards here tonight that'll be matched up against one another. Number two is a guy that can flat out shoot the basketball. He has got a beautiful stroke.
His counterpart tonight is known for being a true leader out there on the court. Could be the one controlling the tempo tonight.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. The Cowboys are looking to make this one a blowout early. What are the keys for them tonight, Dick?
Yeah, tonight like this, the keys are pretty simple, Brad. First, make sure every possession you have is a good possession. Don't turn the rock over. Second of all, don't get lazy, man. Attack the basket, grab the glass, get after the boards. Thirdly, play solid fundamental defense, and don't get caught gambling.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. The fake. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Tries for two. And in and out. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Stolen away.
There it is. Jam City.
Now that's what I call showtime.
You better believe it, baby.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. And one too many dribbles and a steal. Jumps into the defender. The Cyclones have got to continue to get him the ball.
Brady's on fire.
On the dribble, gives it up.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. They work the perimeter. He looks for three. Goes in. Obvious foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He'll regroup the offense. On the outside, he can't shake the pressure. For two, and the ball goes out of play. He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. Working it around the perimeter. The small forward gets the pass.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Iowa State is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. He kept his dribble and ran the defender right off the screen for a beautiful jump shot, Brad.
Inside. Just too slow to stay with his man, Dick, and he picks up the foul.
Well, two mistakes. Number one, he lets him get the ball in that deep. And number two, he doesn't have any footwork and doesn't move and beat him to the spot.
Fed the low block. Hickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Inside, the center gets the ball. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job by the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Goes up for two. And he missed. Trying to pack it inside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's block shot usually creates momentum and opportunity.
The center with the ball. And he'll kick it back outside from beyond the arc. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Entry pass in the paint. He hits it.
Roll it back again, fellas. There's the screen up on top.
Kicks it out. He looks for the bomb. Oh, yes.
Great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
Here's a flash from the high post. The small forward takes the feed. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper.
He got his jumper off by running that defender into the screen.
Moving it around the perimeter.
Great anticipation defensively.
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. On the inside. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
The dribble, gives it up.
There he is, strips the ball loose.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He fakes the shot. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
He takes the shot from the baseline. He gets the shot to fall.
That basketball. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Puts it up, looking for contact. And he scores despite the hack. Fakes it. Foul charge. Oh, and look at the crowd, and look at the reaction.
I think the whole fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
They're working around the perimeter. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
And the fans are going wild.
The man is off the charts, Brad.
Number 34 with the fake. Tries for two.
I tell you, does a great job getting post position. Hey, Brad, that shot's impossible to stop. It's unbelievable. It's not utilized enough. A little frustration right there.
The shooting guard takes the pass. Good move using the pro hop to draw the foul.
Hey, the defense is a little slow reacting there.
Oh, look at him sneering at the crowd. They won't like that one bit.
Brad, the players are feeling it, and they want everyone to know that they're feeling it.
The Cyclones go to the line for the first time in this game. Makes his first. Terrible free throw. He gets the rebound. Turns it over. Looking for a good shot. He goes with a baby hook. Iowa State are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
down in the low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post. They scored 7 in a row. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle. Was locking.
He makes the block. And the ball goes out of bounds. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
With the jump hook.
That's a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
In the paint.
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Low got a post. Nice screen. Way off target.
Oh, right there. They missed him inside. You got to get the ball when a guy is open. That's a special art, feeding the post.
They move it into the front court. They work the perimeter. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
Picked off. On the outside. Trying to draw some contact. Perfectly executed.
That's 7 unanswered.
These fans have had very little to cheer about. The silence in here is almost deafening. And a momentary look from three-point land. Here's a double team. He blocks the shot. Here we go on the break. Goes up for two. Dick, you think they're going to stay this hot?
Hey, it doesn't look like they're slowing down, my friend.
Moving it around the perimeter. He takes it away. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Hey, the crowd loved that one, Brad. But did you see the mascot? He's so excited. I think he may pull something up there jumping around like that. He's going to get hurt. Hey, don't hurt yourself, big fella. They need you to cheer. Coming inside.
Entry pass in the paint.
Jam City, baby. That's a rim rocker.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
A high screen.
There's the trap.
He launches a three. Scorches the net. Wide open for the shot. He shoots from the top of the circle.
He kept the ball on the floor and waited for his teammate to set that screen for the sweet jumper. Boy, that was beautiful.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He takes a three. It sticks. They work it around the perimeter. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, in regards to our player matchup, it's a matter of one guy focusing and taking advantage of shot opportunities. He seems to be making the most of it tonight.
All right, thanks, Aaron. For the bucket.
I tell you, you got to be exceptional to make that shot, because a lot of coaches don't like it because you're going away. You're not in rebound position. You better make it count.
Gave it up.
Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
They work it around the perimeter.
Everything they throw up keeps hitting the target. NBN, nothing but nylon.
Kicks off the lazy pass.
Look at that spacing.
Intercepted. Tries for two. That's good. There they come with a double team to stop it. Iowa State are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, that'll keep pushing and seeing if they can force a timeout.
Whistle and foul. Coach not happy on the sideline. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
They'll work it around the arc.
Coach looks on. Focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
He was doing a great job pressuring the ball and decided to go for the steal. A questionable decision, though, on his part, because it resulted in a foul.
Hey, defenders must be confident we're going for a steal. If not, it'll often end up with a personal foul.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the first shot.
Strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up. Picked out of the air. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. Here's the three ball. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Looking for a good shot. Too physical. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, it's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think he takes the hard hack in the air, but he lays the ball in.
That's what you take for the team, Brad.
The Cowboys are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. It's good.
That was a great, great effort right there. Trying to play that passing lane. Anticipating really well.
Whistle blown. Basket's good and one.
That's concentration, baby.
To the line. Makes the foul shot. Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. There's a double team waiting there. He strokes it. You betcha. He's getting lost on every move.
We gotta see more heart on defense.
Moving around the perimeter. Picks off the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Searcy is pretty fired up and excited.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
And he'll kick it back outside.
Get that sucker out of the game, man.
They work the perimeter. Steals a pass.
Easy Duke coming here, Brad.
Jumps in. He puts it in with contact and all. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Easy one. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 7.
Had a shot block.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
He tries the three ball. Nice shot. He shoots from the top of the circle. He drills it from beyond the arc. Another turnover.
We're not talking apple turnovers either. I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little dipsy dude dunkaroo.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
On the outside. In the paint. For two. Basket falls despite the contact. Is getting some love from the crowd now.
He's very popular, Brad. He has done some great things on the court, and the people really appreciate him for it.
The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting the good inside angle, a poor job defensively, no help. I mean, that is post play at its best.
And a momentary look from three-point land. He gets the rejection. Fake. There's the pick. There's the roll. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. Up fake. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. Oh, what a strip, Brad. Let's see if they go 2-for-1 here, Brad.
Oh, that mascot looks like a lost puppy dog, Dick.
I tell you, the mascot's so sad, it reflects their play.
Number 21 gets in on his first minutes tonight.
Hey, this kid really knows how to keep the offense moving. Tremendous leader out there.
Gets two at the charity stripe. Has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Three balls paying dividends tonight, Dick.
That's right, Brad. All their bills are getting paid from New York, baby.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Fires away. It's good. Moving it around the perimeter. Three. way off target. At halftime, the Cyclones lead by 29. Has not shown his usual productivity on offense.
But you know what, Brad? He's still having a decent game. What's more important is for the rest of the team to pick up the slack in the second half.
Dick, it's all about teamwork, and as we start the second half and take a look at our player matchup update, it's pretty even.
That's a really great balance out there, because you look at the stars right now, they're getting the ball in the right place on the court where they can be effective. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking out of box.
He looks at the hoop. And now there's a whistle and a foul. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
He attempts a jump hook.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. He intercepts it. This should be an easy bucket. Looking for contact. Perfectly executed.
Up and inside.
The shot from the baseline. He's good for another score.
Hands in his face. Any time now, boys?
He's got an open look for the shot. He pulls the trigger. Knocks it down. It off him. Fast break possibility coming. The post kicks it back out. Here's a flash from the post up high. Here he is defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
And no foul call either way.
Wow, no call. I can't believe that one.
On the dribble, gives it up. The ball goes out of bounds. It around the arc, lets it fly off the rim and no good.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Work the perimeter. He attempts the trifecta. Sinks it. We get another look. He rejects it. Pump fakes.
Nice fake.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two. They still don't score. Perimeter. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork beating to the spot.
We need to see that again, Brad.
Dick, he's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
For the bucket. Oh, yes. Takes away the pass. He shoots from outside, makes the shot. He bombs from outside, drains the shot. Moving it around the perimeter. Picked off. It's a fast break possibility. Tries for two. Perfectly executed.
I want to see that again.
They work it around the perimeter. Here's a double team. Stolen ball. Here they go into transition for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Goes up for two.
I love this guy, Hawk. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use him?
Double team now. Bad angle.
Steal. They get out on the break. For the bucket. He gets the bucket to fall. For two, doesn't go, he makes the block.
Great defensive play, anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Tries for two, perfectly executed.
We'll show you another angle from the booth.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Gave it up. Picks off the lazy pass. Fires it down. Using his size with a power move.
Oh, what a power goal. Jump stop, takes the ball to the goal, strong.
paint. Rejects it. With the fake. From the baseline. Makes it. On the outside. He puts up the tray. He buries it. These guys are scoring at will.
Hey, the defense is falling and they can't get up, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Dick, that's what I call giving him the business.
He's definitely giving him the business. I can do without that twatting, though.
They're working around the perimeter. And they come with a double team to stop it. He throws it up from downtown. That was nice.
There's the trap.
Gave it up. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Try to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's fluffing, baby.
He missed on the steal. That's going to be the offense's game.
Yes, sir. They got the advantage right there once he misses that gamble.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad, the player matchup has been our focus tonight, and he's been effective because his teammates are finding him in the right spots, and he's knocking down all his shots, guys.
He hits the shot. The Cyclones are ahead by 25. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Taken away. They get it out into transition.
Great elevator man, man. That's the elevator guy. What a high riser.
The ball goes out of play. Boy, it's so important when you're getting points off turnovers. Look at that stat.
I'll tell you one thing. Coaches go nuts. If that stat's negative, it absolutely makes you lose the air and you get balled like I am.
Way off target. On the dribble, gives it up. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
A nice look at the basket from the top of the key. Perfectly designed, perfectly executed, easy basket. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Dump it inside.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
Time to talk it over. We've got a timeout. start again. Looking for a good shot. Gave it up. He shoots from right of the circle.
Awesome job of running his guy into the screen to get off that J.
On the dribble, gives it up, and the ball goes out of play.
By the D. I love it.
High post flashes for the opportunity. He takes the shot off the baseline.
Boy, he gotta knock those down. Great screen, but no go.
Picks off the pass. Gave it up. Stolen.
He got the ball back down. The floor is stripped up.
He launches a three. It sticks.
Spacing.
Steals a pass.
Nice high post screen. Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Here's a spin down to the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, and now the spin move to the goal.
Jumped in front to take it away. Cross court. Went away from the post and goes the other way. He shoots from right of the circle. He drains the trifecta. They're working around the perimeter. Hinton in the paint. There's a double team waiting there. And you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They'll work it around the arc. Good fake. He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. And the ball goes out of bounds. There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important.
Gets it back out. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. This game's out of reach.
It sure is, Brad. They have no chance of getting back into this one.
With a bucket.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
He shoots from left of the circle. The Cyclones have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Problem with that when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you front it.
He intercepts it. On the dribble, gives it up. Gave it up. Tries for two. Perfectly executed.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
They work the perimeter. Reese in the post.
The pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
He takes the shot from the baseline.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down on the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Vicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
For two, it's good. Working it around the perimeter. Goes for the deep one. Tickles a twine. Moving it around the perimeter. And a momentary look from three-point land. Get ready to bounce back into action here. He puts up the three ball. Way off target. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
Play results in a backcourt violation.
You have to take care of the rock, baby.
Nick, let's take a look at right now at our backcourt production.
Hey, team success depends on backcourt production, Brad. If you can handle the rock, make good decisions, penetrate, and knock down the open jumper, you give yourself a great opportunity to get to the winner's circle.
Drains it. I think he's trying to throw his opponent off his game by taunting him.
Hey, look at that, Brad. He's getting in his opponent's face.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Dump it inside.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Gave it up. In the post. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Time expires on the shot clock.
That's fantastic D, Brad. What happened was that the defense took away every conceivable good look at the basket.
Throws up the prayer. Off the rim and no good. Dick, you look back, it was a great matchup. We expected it to be, and it turned out to be everything we'd hoped for.
Yeah, they really are. You got to play as a unit. It's all about the team. That's what gets you to the winner's circle.
Oklahoma State couldn't get enough going before the final buzzer.
This is going to be hard to swallow since they were the favorites coming into this game.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.